Hey guys, Sai is here back with another interesting and most important video. And today in this video, I'm gonna talk about best settings and frequencies on Franco Kernel Manager APK, which help to boost your battery backup to 2x. Definitely watch this video till then because you will get a very informative information on this video. Okay, and this video is for rooted users, especially for rooted users, but also I will cover some important settings whose device is not rooted. That means in this video I am going to cover two methods, one for root users and other one for non-root users. So definitely watch this video till the end and also note some important points. The first important point is please take full backup of your device before move on the process. Okay, maybe your data loss maybe happen, so definitely take your important data on your SD card, pen drive, laptop, PC, whatever you have. Okay, and second important point is if your device is rooted with patch method, so please put your unpatched boot IMG on any SD card, pen drive, or laptop, PC, or another phone. Okay, because if you face any issue with after doing this settings, so maybe your device gone on boot loop or whatever, something maybe will be happen with your device, then simply you can flash that stock boot IMG, that means unpatched boot IMG, so your device will be recovered. Okay, so let's move on the process. Okay, let's talk about method for rooted users. So my device is rooted with kernel SU. No matter if your device rooted with Apache, kernel SU, Magisk. Okay, but if your device is rooted with kernel SU or Apache, then you need to give root permission to kernel Franco Kernel Manager APK. Okay, install this application, download this application and install this application. After that, give the root permission, root access to the Franco Kernel Manager APK. Okay, after that, open the Franco Kernel Manager APK and go on CPU section. And here it is, first setting which we need to do, that is maximum frequency. So set maximum frequency in little cluster and big cluster 50%. So here it is, I have maximum frequency 1700 something, so I'm going to set the 50% of this 1700, so I'm going to set 998. So in your case maybe the value is different, but set the 50% value of maximum of 50%. Okay, so set the both values 50% on little cluster and big cluster. Okay, so I set it. After setting, please enable the toggle because it will apply after boot. So, and also set CPU governor to power save. Okay, in little cluster and big cluster, set CPU governor power save and enable the toggles after applying successfully this settings. Note this point. Okay, so I applied all the settings. Now talking about minimum frequency, so set the minimum frequency least frequency is 300, so set greater than least. Okay, least frequency, minimum frequency set least frequency greater than. Okay, so after settings enable it. Okay, so here it is, in a big cluster least frequency is 300, so I set one more level. Okay, so definitely note this point, don't set exactly least. Okay, simply set more than least. Okay, so after applying this to big cluster and little cluster, now next move on the next settings, go on CAF CPU boost. Okay, here it is, we have a little cluster input boost frequency, so set this boost frequency, you can set it 300 to 600, but better if you set it 300. Okay, little and big, set both as a 300 megahertz. Okay, and enable this both toggles. Okay, so please note this point, set both the frequencies at last least frequencies, which is in my case 300. Okay, so in your case maybe it will less or greater, so set only very least frequency. So in my case 300 is my least frequency. So after setting least frequency, simply allow the toggles. Okay, now go back, now move on next settings. Okay, what is that? We need to go on this core. Okay, set on boot, simply enable this toggle and disable the big cores. So here it is, the both cores are big cores, CPU 6 and CPU 7. Here it is that this both cores are big cores. Okay, so disable this big cores. Big cores is useful when you perform very high tasks like playing games or something. Okay, so for heavy tasks, big cores are useful, but normal tasks we no need to use this big cores. Okay, so leave this, ignore this big cores, and disable. After disabling this two cores, which is big cores, enable the toggle at the right side of the top, right? Note this point. Okay, because we are going to save the battery, we are going to do saving the battery, so we don't, so on heavy task the CPU take a lot of power, so we disable that CPU, big core CPUs. Okay, now move on next setting, which is GPU settings. So now move on GPU settings. On GPU section, so we have also maximum and minimum frequencies, but we need to set only maximum frequency. So first of all, set CPU governor to power save, enable the toggle. Then next setting, go on maximum CPU frequency and set maximum CPU frequency to 50% of higher frequency. So in my case, I set 300 something. Okay, then enable the toggle. Okay, after enabling both toggles, don't change any frequency in minimum frequency. Okay, ignore the minimum frequency, just set maximum frequency to 50% of max frequency. Now move on memory. Okay, the next section is memory session. In memory session we have a IO. So in IO scheduler we need to set NOOP. Okay, simply set NOOP NOOP in every IO scheduler section. Okay, after set NOOP, enable the toggle. Note this point, after set NOOP, enable the toggle. So set all the IO scheduler to NOOP mode and enable the toggle. Okay, after doing this all settings, move on memory. Okay, now here it is, we have a ZRAM. Okay, so you can set ZRAM to 512, but in some cases maybe it will give you some issues, so you can ignore it. Okay, if you facing any issue after enabling, after putting 512 MB RAM, if you face an issue, then you can leave this setting, set it as a default. Okay, but I am setting it as a default because in my case, when I put it 512, then I will facing some issues, so I am leave this setting as default. Okay, now let's move on the next setting. So here it is, a lot of settings is present. So let's go on vibration. So you can decrease the vibration. Okay, so your strength. So what happen if you decrease the vibration strength, then power consumption will be less. Okay, so better if you turn off this vibrations. Okay, like we don't have any vibration feel when you use keyboard or something, or notification vibration or call vibration. So yeah, call vibration is mandatory, so you can set its intensity at low. Okay, so now that's it. Now move on next section, which is battery. So click on start and this part. Okay, start and options. So here it is, we need to enable battery monitor service. Okay, enable the first toggle of this options, battery monitor service, enable that toggle, and that's it. This toggle, when you enable this toggle, FKM monitor the background apps and shut down if any background application take max power. Okay, so this is very useful. So enable the battery monitor service toggle, after that go back. Now here it is, all the settings done. Okay, now you can reboot your device once, after that the settings is successfully applied, that's it. Okay, here it is, my device is turned on and all the settings is applied successfully. Okay, in your case, if you face any issues like very lag issue or highly slow your device, if you feel highly slowed your device, then you can increase one level extra of frequency. Okay, note this point, if you face if you facing a very lag or very high slow feeling like this. If you feel any slow, your device is very slow, then you can increase little bit higher level of your frequencies. That means you set 50% now, so you can set 60%, 70% of your frequency. Okay, so do this experiment by your own, because every device have a different processor, so maybe some frequencies may be suitable, some frequencies may be not. So do experiment by yourself. Simply increase the level of frequency. Okay, so it will help you. Okay, now let's talk about process for non-root users. So simply non-root users install FKM, that means Franco Kernel Manager APK. Open the FKM, then enable the toggle of battery monitor service. Okay, this only one setting will be applied successfully on non-rooted users. Okay, because for using FKM we need rooted device. Okay, so we don't have rooted device, so you can only apply this one setting. Okay, after applying that one setting, please disable battery optimization of for FKM. okay, this is first setting. Now move on second settings, use dark mode. Okay, and then next, use night light, because it will decrease blue light, so battery consumption will be low. Okay, now move on settings and some other settings which you need to do. Disable this double tap to wake and double tap to sleep, because the sensors which always active on every time, so that sensors will be disabled. That means power consumption will be decreased. Okay, now move on next. You can set some important vibration disable, so you can disable some important sounds and vibrations, like here it is, touch sounds, dial pad sounds. To disable this, all the sounds, disable the vibration, set your brightness to 50%. Okay, so do this all the settings which helps you to less power consumption of your battery. Okay, so and also you can use some other settings, like you can pause applications. Okay, you can forcefully pause your applications. If that option is not present on your device, then you can simply reboot your device once. So after rebooting, your device will be force stop all the application which is running on background. Okay, so after that rebooting, you can use only those application or that application which only you want to use. Okay, so this is very helpful to increase boost your battery backup for non-root users. So this is the important settings, important frequencies, whatever we call. If you like this video, then please like and share this video. See you in the next video. Love you guys. Goodbye. Take care.